This video is part of a series of videos on DXi replication. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to configure file cartridge-based replication for a NAS share. The configuration process is the same for a VTL partition, but this demonstration will focus on configuring a NAS share. Note that when referring to file cartridge-based replication for the NAS presentation type, the name directory file-based replication is also used in the DXi user interface and documentation. In this demonstration, I'm going to configure a DXi-6800 as the source DXi system and a DXi-8500 as the target DXi system. Note that the configuration process is the same for all DXi-Series systems with 2.3 software. For additional information or for step-by-step procedures on configuring replication, always refer to the user's guide for your DXi system. For an overview of the DXi replication feature, including the different types of replication, watch the DXi-Series replication overview video. When configuring file cartridge replication, there are specific tasks that need to be completed on the source DXi and the target DXi. On the target DXi, I need to add the source DXi as a replication source, add a NAS share, enable directory file-based replication for the share, and configure a sync ID for the share. Then, on the source DXi, I need to add the target DXi as a replication target, configure sync ID for the share, and then run synchronization. So let's start by logging in to our target DXi. Our first step is to add the source DXi system as a replication source. I'm going to use the user interface sitemap to navigate to the green configuration section and select replication. This is where I will define the replication source DXi on the target DXi. Target DXis can receive replicated data from up to 10 different source DXis. For this example, I'm going to configure just one source DXi. Under the Source DXi section, I'll click Add and enter the source IP address. I also need to add a new NAS share on the target DXi that I can use for file-based replication. The share that I'm going to replicate from the source DXi is named BUE Backup, so I'll use the same name on the target DXi system. I also need to enable deduplication and then select the SIFS export protocol. Under replication settings, I need to enable directory file-based replication in the receive section. I also need to add a sync ID, and the ID needs to match what's configured on the source DXi. For this demonstration, I'm going to add BUE Backup as the sync ID, which is the same as the name of the share. Next, I'll set access to unlocked so that I can synchronize data between the shares. If locked is selected, the share would not be able to receive new file-based replication data. With all of my settings entered, I'll then click Apply. I'll click Yes to confirm these settings, and then I'll perform the remaining configuration tasks on the source DXi. Back on the source DXi, I need to add the target DXi as a replication target. I could add up to two target DXi systems, however, for this example, I'm going to add just one. Again, I'm going to use the sitemap to navigate to the green configuration section and select replication. On the replication target and source DXi's page, I need to enter the IP address of the target DXi. Under target DXi's, I'll click Add and enter the target IP address. I'll leave the default encryption setting at 256-bit. 256-bit encryption provides a stronger level of security but may have an impact on system performance in some situations. For best performance, select None for encryption if your data network is already secured. If I had multiple network interfaces configured on this DXi, I would need to specify the IP address of the one configured to send replication data. I would do so in the Source IP Address field. If you are not sure if you have multiple network interfaces configured for different data traffic types, refer to your DXi User's Guide or the DXi-Series Network Configuration video for details on how to identify which interface you have configured for replication. As soon as I click Apply, the system verifies with the target DXi that it is an allowed source. Now, I need to edit the NAS share on the source DXi and configure it for file-based replication by entering the sync ID. To do this, I need to select Replication. Under the Send tab, expand the Shares option, select My NAS Share, and then click Configure. I'll select Enable Replication, then Enable Directory File-Based Replication to target. I'll enter the BUE Backup Sync ID that I configured on the target DXi system. Remember, the sync IDs on the target and source DXi systems must match for file-based replication to work. Now, I have configured file-based replication on the source DXi and target DXi and need to run synchronization to make sure that I have the same data on both shares. I'll click Synchronize now for the BUE Backup Share. The synchronization process completes when Success displays in the status column. When this happens, the shares on the source DXi and target DXi are in sync. I can select the Queue button to watch the progress of the synchronization or to view the statistics for any shares or partitions configured for file cartridge-based replication. Now, with file-based replication configured, replication and recovery occur automatically after a file is closed in a SIF share. No manual intervention or scheduling is needed. When files are deleted on the source DXi system, they are automatically removed from the target DXi system. When new files are added to the source DXi system, they are automatically added to the target DXi as well. In this video, I demonstrated how to configure file cartridge replication. For an overview on how to configure continuous namespace replication, or to watch the other videos in this series, click the links shown here. For more information about replication, always refer to the user's guide for your DXi system.